Hi, it's Jason Hartman, and we are continuing our discussion today on the 10 commandments of successful investing. Let's talk about number 5. Do any of you like to gamble? Yeah, maybe you do. Maybe you go to places like Lost Wages, Nevada, right? A terrible place that just steals people's money, right? And maybe you do that for entertainment, and hopefully you limit yourself and you limit your budget when you gamble, right? But investing is not about gambling. Investing is the legitimate process of creating value over time. Now, I have a very simple way for you to know if you are an investor or if you are a gambler or speculator, right? Very simple way. It is this simple. If you want to know if you are an investor and you want to know if you have an investment that you are considering, there's only one question you need to answer. You ready? Does it produce income? Does it produce income? If it does not produce income, it is not an investment. It is simply a speculation. It is simply a gamble. Right? There are many investors, well, I should say people who call themselves investors, bless their hearts, and I used to be one of these, right? But I got a little older, I got a little more conservative, and I thought, you know, it's kind of hard to earn your money. I don't want to lose it anymore, right? So I want to be an investor, not a speculator, not a gambler. I like to invest for yield, for cash flow, for ROI, return on investment. As you go along. See, the problem with investing for capital appreciation, you know, the old mantra of the non-dividend paying stock investor, the precious metals investor, the cryptocurrency investor, or the investor, well, they call themselves an investor, in real estate, in a cyclical market, which we will talk about that in the future, the three different types of real estate markets, that type of investor, or really speculator, is doing the buy low, sell high business plan, right? The buy low, sell high. The problem is, I have never, in all my years in the business, and I've been doing this a long time, since I was 19 years old in my first year of college, I got into real estate. I always wanted to be a real estate investor since I was 16 years old. And in all that time, I have never met anybody who can accurately predict the cycles in the real estate market. Yes, I've met quite a few gurus who claim to be good at this, and they'll be good for a while, okay? And then they'll be wrong. They'll be good until they're wrong, right? You know, there's an old saying, a broken clock is right twice a day, okay? We all know that. So with this, you don't want to gamble. You want to invest for cash flow. If you are buying properties in these cyclical markets, right? The markets where if you're looking at a graph, they go up, and then they go down, and then they go up again, and they go down. That's a cyclical market versus a linear market that has little ups and downs, but they're minor. It just kind of chugs along and does its thing over time. And the linear markets have very good cash flow versus the cyclical markets that have terrible cash flow. So you are stuck in the environment where you must buy low and sell high, and you must time the market accurately. That is not investing. That does not produce income. That's why we know it's not investing. If it doesn't produce income, it's not an investment. It's a gamble. Commandment number 5, be sure to obey this one, thou shalt not gamble. Now, one caveat on that. I know I said don't gamble and follow commandment number 5. However, if you are doing well and you have achieved some financial success, whatever that means to you, and you've got a little money to speculate with and take a gamble with, that's okay. Okay, if you take 10 or 15 or maybe even 20% of your net worth, depending on how high your net worth is, and you gamble with it and you think, hey, you know, I might hit a home run here, and you might, then that's okay. I don't want to say that you can't do this. I'm just saying, depending on your age, and in the prior video, we talked about financial planning, depending on your risk tolerance, your time horizon, your investment goals, right? Tie it back to that one. You want to consider investing for cash flow, for yield. That's an investment, something that produces income versus something that's speculative. So I hope that helps. And I want to wish you all happy investing. If you have a comment, leave it below or go to jasonhartman.com/ask questions or comments. And we will see you on the next video. Until then, happy investing.